In this video, we're going to look at the triple integral. It's a simple extension, really, of the double integral, and we'll use an example here of what is analogous to a type 1 region in the double integral. In this instance, we simply have a surface in 3D space that becomes our area, our volume, actually, D. And here's our equation. We have the triple integral over this volume D of a function in 3 variables that is over some differential volume. And look at the end. It is dz, dy, dx, where z is expressed, first of all, the inner integral of our iterated integral as between the, an equation in h of x and y, h1 and h2. Then we move to dy, which will be between a function g of x, g1 of x to g2 of x, and then right on the outside with respect to x, we take an integral between two constants. So let's look at this example. Calculate the integral of the f of x, y, z equals x over the tetrahedron D formed by the intersections here of the xy plane, the xz plane, and the yz plane, and the plane z equals 2 minus x minus y. And we have a beautiful illustration here of this. Our red area really is this, this plane lying in z equals 2 minus x minus y. And if you think about it, if we said z equals 0, so we're just going to look at this bottom yz plane. If z equals 0, then we have x plus y equals 2. And really y equals 2 minus x, if we just solve for y. And if we let both z and y equal 0, then we're just left with x equals 2. So that sets our volume D in x, y, and z of the x going from 0 to 2. Well, let's start right at the end. Really, the z is going to go from 0 till 2 minus x minus y. Now, our next function, which will be the g1 and g2, think about it, if z equals 0, we just have this line lying right at the bottom between the x and the y-axis, actually that whole plane. And y is going to go from 0 till this line, end of the line in the xy plane, which is 2 minus x. And then x will just simply go from the yz plane, where x equals 0 at the back, to the front, where x equals 2. So we've set up our triple integral there. First of all, we're going to do the inner integral, that is with respect to z, which simply will bring z into our x, and that goes from 0 to 2 minus x minus y. We see the solution there once we plug in those values. We have our middle integral, if I can call it that now, with respect to y. Still, we have the dx left, and that's easy to do. You see it there, and when we replace the values going from 0 to 2 minus x, for every y that we have in this 2xy minus x squared y minus half xy squared, we are left with 2x minus 2x squared plus a half x cubed. Single integral now going from 0 to 2 with respect to x. Quite simple to do, and you'll also end up, or should end up, with an answer of 2/3.